Hey, what's going on, guys? Bricks Films here, back with a new video, and today we are going over the 2007 AT-ST. The set number 7657, and it retailed for $20, and it came with 244 pieces and one minifig. So, this is probably my favorite AT-ST that LEGO has ever made. I have always liked how the smoothness of the side, you can already kind of see it. And I don't know, I think this one just looks really good. I think it's like kind of the most size accurate, even though the newer ones are apparently more size accurate. This one just looks better, if that makes any sense. So before we get into the minifig, let's look at the directions, and probably my favorite part of these older sets, and that's the directions. I just like seeing how they've changed. The back page of this one got ripped out, unfortunately. Kind of show you what was going on at the time, and this is why I think this set is my favorite, is because those two battle packs are the first battle packs they ever released, and I loved those battle packs. They were so awesome, and yeah, this was a good wave. Came with the first battle packs, came with awesome looking Y-Wing, pretty cool drop ship, and then of course General Grease's Starfighter. So, and then probably my favorite thing about the directions is this I loved. I remember seeing this in the back of the battle packs. Wait, no, it was the AT-AP for 2007. They had this too, and it was so awesome. I loved looking at it, and yeah, I just think this looks awesome. So, and then the rest of it just kind of shows you what it can do, which we'll get to, and then, you know, not much. But also to note, this was at the time when they didn't show you what parts you needed for each step, so it kind of made it difficult. And yeah, nice box art, aka booklet art, or whatever you want to call it. So yeah, now let's look at the one minifig they give you. It's just a normal AT-ST pilot. Came with one of the medium-sized blasters. Nice looking head, not double-sided, and no back printing. Nothing special, just one normal AT-ST pilot. So that's that. Now, I guess we'll get into the build, so I'll see you guys there. Alrighty, so now that we got the camera readjusted, we're gonna look at the build. So, first of all, we'll look at the action feature of this set, and you know, you can move this head around, and that's nice with your hands, but what you can do is use this knob on the back to move it around like that. And that's pretty cool. They do that with all the other AT-STs, as far as I know. I'm not sure about the oldest one, but they've done that with all of them. Yeah, so otherwise there's not too much action features on the set. You can move these guns up that much, that's it. You can move this gun on the side, you can move this gun on the side, which you got to be careful with those binoculars because they are fragile. And then leg rotation, obviously you can move it around like that, and it's kind of interesting they use the hinged pieces instead of the like normal ones they use now for AT-ST. So that's that. Nice detail on the back, and then of course you can flip this open, and you flip that open, can't really see inside there, but we'll get to that in a second. But what you can do is sit a guy up here, so he's sitting. And, oh, you can't really see him there. So you can sit like that without holding this handlebar. I mean, you can have him hold the handlebar, but he can also sit like that. And I'll show you how he's sitting like that right now. So right there, you can kind of see, if we rotate this around and we take him off it, he just sits on those two suds right there up against it. So that's how that works. And then otherwise, I mean, kind of hard to see in there. We'll kind of point it towards the light. Readjust this. Kind of hard to see. It's just one chair and that's it. And then a place to hold your gun. Otherwise, kind of plain in there, but adds place to add in whatever you want. So yeah, and that's going to be it for this set. So let's get into the final thoughts. So final thoughts on this set is I think it's one of the best AT-ST sets that we've ever gotten. I honestly think it competes with the, not the newest AT-ST, but the Rogue One one. That one. I think it really competes with that one. Rogue One AT-ST was, I believe, $40, which was a pretty good price for how big it was. But I really like this one. And for $20, I think you're getting a really good deal. My only complaints about it, it would probably be just one lacking minifig. Like, they could have just thrown in a scout trooper because it's on Endor, or even a normal stormtrooper, and I think this would have been A-plus tier set. Otherwise, I think it's an A, considering that it's only $20 at the time, and now it's, with inflation, maybe at the highest is 25, maybe probably 23 only. But yeah, this set is awesome. If they were to remake it and make it 25, I would buy another one probably. So yeah, that's gonna do it for this video. If you guys enjoy these older Lego sets, just tell me down in the comments. And if you want to see me do some newer ones, just say something in the comments, you know what I mean? So that's gonna do it for this video, and yeah, peace out.